We did study the vowels, the consonants, and the combination of these two types, which become as the consonantal vowels. There are 12 vowels and 18 consonants, and in combination we get consonantal vowels. That is to say, it is ik, a consonant, plus a vowel. The result is ka, a consonantal vowel. Ik plus a became ka. This is elongated. A is an elongation of a. So naturally, the consonantal vowel gets an elongated sound, ka. With this combination also, we saw a few words. For instance, call. Call is a leg. This is kal. Ka and il. This is ka and il. This means a leg and this means a stone. So the elongation of the consonantal vowel brings in a difference in the meaning. Call and kal. What is this? Non and non. Non is the capital I. Non. And here we did discuss a grammatical point. That is to say, this na will rarely come as the last letter of any Tamil word, and this na can never be the first letter of any Tamil word. Another vowel, the third vowel, I. So what will be the combination? Combination is ki. How do we write it? This is ka, as you know, and you put a curl at the end of the right side. From the right end, you elongate the line, make a curl, bring it down, and end it equally along the letter. So this is ki. So naturally, the next letter we take up is na and e. This is ni. The one thing which we have to remember in writing these letters is where to start the marker. We can call it a marker, a mark which makes the letter to sound differently. If there is no marker, it is ka. With this marker, it is ki. And as we saw earlier, this is a marker, and when it is added to a consonantal vowel, the whole becomes one elongated letter ka. Now, like that, we have a marker to denote the vowel e. So ik plus e, ki. Next letter ng plus e, ni. This is ki. As you have in the English words kill, kit, and kin. It, ta, with a dot above, and you add a vowel e and it becomes t. Now you don't have any right end ending. Where do you start? So you have to put it in the middle. So the way it is written is ta in the middle you take this bend, extend it, and this becomes T, as you have in tin, tip and tick. N plus E, ni. Ka, na, cha, nya, ta, na. Then the next letter is ta. With a dot above, it becomes it. And you add this vowel, it becomes T. Now we have the next letter ni. This is a combination of N or N plus E, ni. Ni. After na you have pa, if plus e, this becomes p. See, I take the curve from the right end, if plus e, p, plus e is ni. Here you have to notice, as you don't have any right edge, you have to start on the very letter, in the middle of the letter, that is ma, and in the middle of the letter you take this marker and extend it. This is ni, ya, with a dot above the consonant. R with a consonant. You put a vowel and it becomes E. Please note, I start from the right end. E plus E, E. This E is a back vowel and E happens to be a middle one, and with R you have re, R plus E, re. Please note, in R you have that this extension at the end, and when you add a vowel you need not have this extension, because without this extension it is not going to be different in pronunciation. The next letter is L plus E, li. This is la, and you have this marker here. This is L plus E, li. Lip, limb and lit. The next letter is, as you know, U, that is wa with a dot above, and in combination it becomes wa and V. U plus E, V. Now I would like to suggest again this re, li, re, and ni are at the end of the consonants. Let us have a few words. This exercise will give you a chance to remember the pronunciation and also practice writing it with pronunciation. This is a vowel. I hope you don't doubt it. What is this? A. What is this? Li. Only now we have learned that. A. Li. A. Li. A. Li. A. Li. Both of them are short. Short A and short Li. A. Li. A. Li. A rat. What is this letter? A. Elongation of A. A. This is Ri. A. Ri. This is a long letter and it's a short one. A. Ri. A lake. Very recently we learned this. Ki. And what is this? Li. Ki. Li. Ki. Li. Ki. Li. Ki. Li. Ki. Li. Ki. Li. A parrot. This is Ma. You have Ni with that. Mani. Mani has two meanings. One is a bell and the other one is the time, hour. I think we can learn it later. Remember that mani is a bell. Yeli, yeri, kili, mani. I have used the consonantal vowel E at the end. Now, let me move this to the middle. Can you read this on your own? This is Ma. Yi. Il. Ma. Yi. Il. Mayil. A peacock. The next one is Anil. A-ni-il. Anil. Anil, a squirrel. Now, I would like to introduce the important word, that is, we have been learning Tamil. Tamil, as you write in English, T-A-M-I-L. But what is the actual name of that in that particular language? It is Tamil. Now you know all these sounds and characters. So you must be able to write and also pronounce Tamil correctly. So what will be the spelling of Tamil in Tamil? Ka. Mi. Il. I am not going to write the equivalent or the spelling, the pronunciation in English. This is Ta. Mi. Il. Tamil. Tamil is the name of the language we learn now. Ka. Ri. Kari. Kari as a noun means a stick. And as a verb, to tear into pieces. We have learned words consisting of two letters and three letters. We have also learned the words in which the vowel consonant or consonantal vowel E occurring either at the end or in the middle. With this, I would like to introduce a few important points to be noted and remembered. We have seen the vowels, you must know the Tamil name for vowels, it is uyir. Uyir also means a soul. Uyir also stands for the vowels in Tamil. So, uyir, vowels, and consonants. And their combination called consonantal vowel. With these three types of letters, we try to learn a few words. And there are thousands and thousands and thousands of Tamil words available. They are available both in the speech, in the spoken language, and in literature. So here it will not be out of place to know a few points which can help you remember the basic thing. One type of letters are vowels and they are 12 in number. Another type of letters are called consonants. They are 18 in number. And we have consonantal vowels which are made out of the consonant plus vowel. So that will be 18 into 12. I am not giving you the multiplication. One set of letters called vowels, another set called consonants, the third set consonantal vowel. These three types make all the letters of the orthography or the letters of the Tamil language.